Pleasant day, dear grade 12 learners! Welcome to Bamboo Tel Escuela! I am Teacher Melanie M. Ventura, your teacher on air in creative writing. Before we start our discussion, be sure that you are in a comfortable place and tune in to DWDYAM, CMD Cable, or SDO Kawayan Facebook page live streaming. All you have to do is to relax, watch or listen attentively, and just pay attention on the content of the discussion, not on the details of my face, for you to clearly understand the topic. In your previous lesson, you learned that there are two divisions of literature, namely prose, which refers to language form with a natural or common flow of speech, and poetry, which refers to a type of literature in verse or metrical form, and is based on the interplay of words and rhythm. And today, we will deal more on the popular type of prose, which is fiction or fictional prose. So for this session, we will be able to define fiction, identify the various elements of fiction, and differentiate the subtypes of some of the elements. Have you tried reading any novels, short stories, fables, or even legends? If yes, then I guess you can really relate on our topic for this session, which is fiction. Because all of those are actually examples of fiction. So what is fiction? Etymologically, the word fiction has been derived from the Latin word fictus, which means to form. However, in literature, it was defined as literature in a form of prose created from the imagination of the author. Generally, fiction refers to make-believe or invented stories. These are stories that are based on the imagination and creativity of the writer. It can be in a form of short stories, fables, vignettes, plays, or even novels. Now, it is worth noting that although fiction writers may base a character on people that they have met in real life, the characters and the experiences that they face in the story may not be real. Hence, it is still considered fictitious or fiction. All right, now that we have already defined fiction, let us now focus on its elements or the things that make up fiction, which are the following: settings, characters, plot, conflict, point of view, theme, and of course, the tone. Let us start with the setting. The setting of a story is the time and place in which it occurs, or it shows where and when the story takes place. Setting can be based on an actual location, such as Kawayan City, Isabela, or in an imaginary location, such as Neverland. It may also happen in an actual or imaginary time period. It may happen in the present, sometime in the past, or even sometime in the future. Typically, a setting includes the following: a description of the immediate surroundings, the time of the day when the story is happening, the type of weather or atmosphere, the time period when it happened, and of course, the geographical location. All of these elements would help contribute in giving the readers an idea on the setting or on where and when is the story taking place. For example, in the excerpt of the prologue from Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, two households both alike in dignity, in fair Verona where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break the new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. This short excerpt sets off Verona as the city in which the action takes place. For the second element of fiction, we have characters. Characters are the persons, animals, extraordinary beings, or objects given human qualities in the story. They are also considered as the stars in a story, as events in a story revolves around the characters in a way that their actions in the story would lead to other events. Remember that each character has a role or purpose to play, and characters can be classified according to the role they play in the story. So we have protagonist and the antagonist. The protagonist protagonist is the main character of a story, in a way that majority of the plot sequences include him or her. Of course, being the protagonist, his or her main objective is to resolve the conflict presented in the story. The antagonist, on the other hand, opposes the protagonist. Also, the antagonist tends to be hostile in nature. Now, while the protagonist aims to resolve the conflict that is presented, the antagonist usually is the cause of the conflict in the story. And of course, aims to stop the protagonist in resolving the conflict. One of the best examples of protagonists in modern literature is Harry Potter, who has encountered different challenges and struggles in order to find ways to stop his antagonist, who is Lord Voldemort, whose mission is to kill Harry Potter in order to gain immortality and become more powerful. Another way to classify characters is by examining how they change over the course of a story. Group in this way by character development. Character types include the round character, flat character, dynamic character, and the static character. The round character is someone who plays an important role in the story, whose character or trait is complex, dimensional, and well-developed. In contrast, flat character is someone who has no important role in the story, while a round character has complex, dimensional, and well-developed characteristics. A flat character usually has only one or two characteristics. Then we have dynamic and static characters. A dynamic character is one who undergoes an important change in the course of the story. The changes are not changes in circumstance, but changes in some sense within the character. It can be changes in insight or understanding, or it can also be changes in beliefs or values. Dynamic character also refers to one whose attitudes and values are affected by the events in the story. While static character refers to a character who does not undergo substantial emotional change or growth, remaining essentially the same in the end as he or she was at the beginning. We can say then that a static character is one whose personality, attitudes, and beliefs remain fixed no matter what kind of situation he or she encounters. So we're done with the first two elements of fiction, which are setting and characters. Now let's have the next, or the third element, which is the plot. Plot is also known as the storyline or series of events that make up the story. It is where the reader learns what is happening and in what order, and more specifically, how the story develops, unfolds, and moves in time. Plots are typically made up of five elements, and these are usually presented using plot diagram. Starting with the exposition, going to rising action, to climax, down to falling action, and resolution. The exposition introduces characters and settings, as well as the tone of the story. It gives the readers an idea on what the story would be about. It also includes events that introduce the conflict, which leads to complications that will lead to events in the rising action. The rising action refers to the events that the characters encounter. Each event leads to further complications that would lead to the climactic event. Here, the main character is in crisis, and events leading up to facing the conflict begin to unfold. So in this part, the story becomes complicated. The climax is the most intense part of the story, as this is considered to be the turning point in the plot. It is the peak of the story, where a major event occurs in which the main character faces a major enemy, fear, challenge, or other source of conflict. The most action, drama, change, or excitement occurs here. Then we have the falling action, which refers to the events that unfold after the climax. One of the characteristics of the falling action is that it elicits an emotional response from the readers. Here, the story begins to slow down and work towards its end, tying up loose ends. After everything has been settled, we now proceed to the resolution. Resolution provides the closure to the story. This signals that the conflict has been fully resolved. It is also known as the denouement and is like a concluding paragraph that resolves any remaining issues and ends the story. The fourth element of fiction is conflict. Conflict is essential to plot. It is the struggle between the characters in the story or the opposition of forces which ties one incident to another and makes the plot move. Conflict provides crucial tension in any story and is used to drive the plot forward. And it is categorized into two, namely external and internal. External conflict is a struggle with a force outside oneself or the obstacle a character faces in the external world. It sets a character against something or someone beyond his or her control. While internal conflict refers to a struggle within oneself. Here, a person must make a decision, overcome pain, quiet temper, or resist an urge. It is when characters struggle with their own opposing desires or beliefs. It happens within them. There are also various types of external conflict. We have man versus man versus nature, man versus society, man versus supernatural, man versus faith, and of course we have man versus technology. Let us start with man versus man. In this type of conflict, the central character faces opposition from another person or group of people. Or it is when a character struggles or fights directly against another character. Or when one character attempts to stop the other from reaching his or her own goal. It is the typical protagonist versus antagonist or hero and a villain situation. For example, two girls compete for the same role in the school play. Or a ninja warrior fights a rival clan to avenge his master's death. Another is in the movie Spider-Man, where Peter Parker has to become a Spider-Man and take Green Goblin to the task, or else Goblin will kill him. They come face to face and the war begins, in which only one of them will survive at the end. Another type of conflict is man versus nature. Here, a character struggles with the force of nature, like natural disasters, desolation, animals, and many more. Usually, the character is struggling to survive. For instance, a ship captain pursues a great white whale through stormy seas. Then there is also man versus society. In this conflict, a character or a group of characters fight against the society in which they live. The characters fight against social traditions, institutions, laws, or rules. In this type of conflict, society becomes a character of its own. It is usually used to comment on positive or negative aspects of real society. For instance, a student takes his fight against the school dress code all the way to the court. Another is man versus supernatural, which is a conflict between a character and something that is not normal in some way. Here, the main character is challenged by forces that are not of this world or by supernatural elements, including ghosts, omens, and superstitions. Like when a character is struggling to protect his community from evil monsters. And then the fifth type of external conflict, we have man versus fate. It is also an external conflict which occurs when a character is trapped by an inevitable destiny. The Greek tragedy Oedipus Rex is an example of this type of conflict, where the main character Oedipus is fated to marry his own mother. The last type of external conflict is man versus technology, where the main character struggles with or against the forces of technology. For instance, a group of strangers gets stuck in an elevator, or a teenage boy is pursued by robots that transform into cars. Now let's have man versus self, which is a type of internal conflict, where the character's struggle takes place in his or her own mind. Here, a character is struggling to overcome fear, addiction, emotional damage, or other crippling personal issue. Usually, it has something to do with a choice, like choosing between right or wrong. Or it may have to do with overcoming emotions or mixed feelings. An obvious example of this is the conflict in Jack London's The Call of the Wild, in which the protagonist, in this case a dog, is torn between a domesticated self and wild self. The fifth element of fiction is point of view. Point of view, or POV, is defined as the perspective from which the story is told. It tells us who is the narrator of the story. There are three main types of point of view: the first, second, and of course, the third person point of view. In the first person point of view, the narrator is a character in the story. The reader sees the story through the narrator's eyes as he or she experiences it and only knows what he or she knows or feels. It uses first-person pronouns like I, me, and we. Here's an example. I bolted out of bed, grabbed my backpack, and rushed out the door. It was the day I was finally going to learn to ride a horse. First-person narrators can only tell us the parts of a story that they experience or already know about. If something happens that the narrator does not know about, we, the readers, won't know about it either. The second person point of view is when you are the character of the story. This is pretty rare. Here, the narrator is speaking directly to you, the reader, and uses the pronoun you. Say for example, you are calm. Your breathing is slow and even. You are sitting on a bench looking at the beach. The beach is calm, and so are you. This kind of point of view usually sounds like it is giving directions to you as the reader. And now we have the most common point of view, which is the third person point of view. It is when the narrator is not a character in the story or is outside the story. A third person narrator uses third personal pronouns like he, she, they, or it, referring to the characters in the story. And there are three main types of third-person point of view. We have the omniscient, limited, and objective. Let us discuss first the omniscient point of view. Omni means all, and sentia means knowledge. So, an omniscient narrator literally knows everything about what's going on in the story. He or she knows what the characters are thinking. The narrator in an omniscient point of view even knows what will happen to the characters in the future. It's like the voice of an all-knowing God. The next type of third-person point of view is limited. Here, the narrator is outside the story too, but he or she only knows what the main character knows, feels, and thinks. If the main character does not know who's hiding around the corner, then the narrator does not know either. And then the third type is objective. This is when the third-person narrator describes what's happening but does not know what anyone is thinking, not even the main character, and does not give opinion about what's happening. It's like a video camera that records the events but only sees the factual surface of events and lets you, the reader, infer what's going on beneath that surface. Now let's proceed to the sixth element of fiction, which is the theme. The theme in a piece of fiction is its controlling idea or its central insight. It is the author's underlying meaning or main idea that he is trying to convey. Some simple examples of common themes from literature, TV, and film are the following. Things are not always as they appear to be. Love is blind. And believe in yourself. But it is important to note that theme is different from subject. A subject is the topic of the story or what the story is about. While theme is an idea that the story expresses about the subject or uses the subject to explore. So for example, in a story, the subject can be love, whereas the theme can be true love waits. Finally, the seventh element of fiction is the tone. When you speak, your tone of voice suggests your attitude. In fact, it suggests two attitudes. One concerning the people you're addressing or your audience, and the other concerning the thing you're talking about or your subject. That's what the term tone means when it is applied to fiction as well. Tone can also mean the general emotional weather of a story, which can be achieved through word choice or diction, sentence construction and word order, or also known as syntax, and by what the viewpoint character focuses on. The tone can be humorous, desperate, clueless, indifferent, and more. All right, I hope you were able to understand the lesson presented. Bear in mind that fiction is a form of prose created in the imagination of its author. It does not aim to tell a true story. Instead, it immerses us in experiences that we may never have in real life, introduces us to types of people we may never otherwise meet, and takes us to places we may never visit in any other way. It can help us see ourselves and our world in new and interesting ways. Remember also that there are seven elements that make up a fiction. These are the setting, characters, plot, conflict, point of view, theme, and the tone. Before we conclude this session, I want you to ponder on this quotation from Virginia Woolf. Fiction is like a spider's web, attached ever so slightly perhaps, but is still attached to life at all four corners. Often, the attachment is scarcely perceptible. So that is all for this session. Again, I am Melanie M. Ventura, your teacher on air in creative writing, where writing is never boring. Thank you for tuning in and have a blessed day, everyone.